morning, everyone, and welcome back. It's time to head north. Heading up to Deer Camp 2021. Sounds like the beginning part of Deer Camp this year. The weather is going to be pretty mild. Lows will be low 30s, upper 20s, but during the day it's going to be in the 40s, and I think there was even a couple of 50s in there. But I've had deer seasons like that before where it's warm in the beginning and I still end up with a 15 below Fahrenheit actual air temperature when I'm sitting on the deer stand by third weekend. Usually when I come up to deer camp, I come up on Thursday, but work was real busy, so I couldn't make it up yesterday. I had to come up this morning. But I also leave on Tuesday or Wednesday, and I'm planning on possibly staying the whole entire week. So that'll make up for it. Shopping took about 45 minutes. It's longer than I thought it was going to. But if you're shopping for possibly a whole week, and Zach's going to be up here, he'll be coming up today, which is Friday, and then he'll hunt Saturday, and then hunt the morning, hunt Sunday, and he'll go back. Sarah's coming up today, and she's staying through Tuesday. And then if I were to stay all week, it takes a lot of food. And it's supposed to be, like I said, pretty mild the beginning part here, so I had to buy 3 20-pound bags of ice. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'm headed to deer camp. Melissa had sent me a picture that I posted on Facebook 4 years ago. This was just a couple of days ago. And I was driving up here for deer hunting, and it was snow everywhere, and I'm driving on this side of the road. Anyway, only one side was plowed, the other one wasn't yet, so a little different this year. They just said on the radio that tomorrow there is an estimated 400,000 hunters will be in the woods in the state of Minnesota for deer. Icy up here. Nothing seems to be out of place in here, but it's cold. I'm gonna start that stove right away. Well, now we have a nice solid handrail, and I redid that thing that holds the wood because that the top piece had rotted out and stuff, so I've been watching it for a while waiting for it to fall over. At first I was going to move this over to here so we can get more wood on the front porch, but it kind of cramps the space here. Now you can stand here, and another thing, this is where the tripod goes when I am doing the gas grill, otherwise it's going to be directly behind me. And now it still fits in there, otherwise you guys are looking at my back instead of what's on the grill. And for those of you that are new that did not watch, I don't know, one of the last tent videos, my dad had hip replacement surgery, And I was watching him when he came over here. I mean, he's still recovering. I think now he's at 9 weeks, 10. I don't know. Anyway, it's still sore, and there was no handrail, so he had a real hard time getting up and down the stairs. And there's been more than once when I've biffed it on those stairs because they get slippery in the winter. So this will just be nice all around for everybody. Much safer. Well, I got most of the stuff, you know, not the meat and everything, out of the truck. I don't have really room for all the vegetables. I'll figure that out. But I did bring up 2 jars of Melissa's homemade salsa. This stuff is her spicy salsa. And this was one that she made 2 batches from scratch. There was a mild, and this is a spicy. And then she made one that was like a package that you put in with your stuff. And that's good too. So I brought up 2 of these and bought some chips. I did remember paper plates. Bought this thing also, and it holds 4 gallons of water because I get so sick. To me, you know, I realize that I use tin foil and paper plates and plastic forks, and that's probably wasteful, I'm sure, you know. But the thing that kills me is bottled water, and I use it up here all the time, and I just think that's the biggest wasteful thing on the whole entire planet. And when you see, like, I watched this thing, like, in the ocean, there's this, like, plastic island that, I mean, it's like 400,000 miles or six, it's just humongous. And so then I sit up here and we use these gallon jugs to do dishes and stuff. And I used to always use that water jug that I put in front of the refrigerator when I leave. But that only holds like 2 gallons. So I wanted to try something like this. And I don't know if I'm gonna like this or not. This spins pretty freely. It even comes with a, I suppose that clicks on there, a little extension thing. This would actually be better if it was up higher, but I'm not going to worry about that. I think this will be a lot better. You have 4 gallons of water right there to do whatever with. Now I just gotta remember not to lose this stuff. I'm gonna drive down to my far stand. I'm not gonna go all the way in on it. I just wanna go in a little bit. There's a couple places where deer will cross that I don't cover from my stand, but I wanna see if there's, there might not be enough snow to see anything in the woods there. I'm not sure, but I'm sure most all of the snow will melt today. Talking to Zachary earlier this week, it sounds like he might want to sit in the tripod stand instead of his regular stand, so we'll see if that's still his idea when he gets up here. I'm not sure. I didn't see anything. Of course, the snow could have fallen last night, but I don't know. I guess we'll see. Well, I'm going to sit down and have a little lunch here. My dad, he is at his place, and it seems like the last two times I was up, when he was up, he showed up during lunch. And then Zachary texted me about 40 minutes ago and said he was about an hour away, so he should be up here pretty quick too.
You want to watch Dan?
Yep.
Yeah, we'll walk in only until the clearing, because sometimes they pass, maybe there was some snow there.
Yep.
No, nothing.
I drove the loop. I didn't see one deer track the whole way.
No.
In the snow.
See, I thought for sure with a little bit of snow, I mean, maybe I would see, you know, so that they would cross right there. But
yep. Right.
Before you, I got started cabin. So with, I looked, there was 30 in the cabin.
Was it? It was 31 in here when I got
is
here.
Is that right, huh?
I got here at 8 minutes after 9. And, yeah. It was chilly.
Yeah, but it's like my trucks at like 45.
Is it? Yeah.
No.
Yeah, it says 49 outside now.
It does. Yeah, because I part of it will be my insurance will pay, I don't know.
Oh yeah, maybe, you know. I shot those two last time I was up here and nothing was in the tent. I didn't think there was any more squirrels around, but there's definitely one up
there. I got two mice and I don't know where they... I mean, all I can think of... Yeah, and I seen yesterday about 6, I walked out there, there was one big mallard just over the edge.
Was there?
Boy, he was a nice big fat one, he would have been good. But otherwise, I don't see any more duck.
I suppose most of them have went south, you know. And I didn't expect it to be froze over. I mean, it'll be all open here. I mean, it's going to be in the 50s.
And blah, 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 blah. Yeah, 50 and blowing out. So.
Yeah, there's already more water open. Like, there was nothing open around the dock, so.
Yeah, because even coming here to the puddles in the road, I thought, man, that's ice.
Yeah, yep. Yeah, I was the first one in. Those birds, as soon as I came up here, they were here, and I got my camera, and I was doing this on the lake like I always do. One hits on my head, one gets on the camera, one's on my arm. I threw out some chips. I keep them stale chips wherever they are, and I threw a few of them out.
Yeah, the other today, Warren had brought off a big bag of some. Not nachos, but they're the bigger ones. Yeah, I put them all out there, and they ate them.
They did, huh?
I mean, how the hell they could have eaten a full bag? Yeah, and I had a 5-piece of bread.
Did ya? Usually once you get over
there. I go in and get licensed and shells, and they don't have any.
Wow. Yep.
Well, I'll have that card right there, so.
Okay,
all right. Yeah, maybe Zach will want to, if she sees anything, shoot it, you know.
He might want to, yeah, yep.
Well, but anyway, let's do it.
Okay.
I shall see you later, Zach.
All right.
Hey.
Hey, come on out.
Here, I got here earlier.
Oh, I got here like that. Yeah. Huh. Otherwise, I seen that George was up at his place, but George has been, he has COVID.
Oh, really?
So he doesn't think he's, it's been enough days now, but he said yesterday, I texted him, he said yesterday was the first, what was it? Yeah, he was going up last night to heat up the cabin, and yesterday was the first day that he felt pretty decent. So. Huh. Yep, so I don't know, like I was telling my dad, usually I'm up here and it's like, I'm so pumped I'm going to get a deer, and this year I don't feel like I'm even going to see one, so maybe I will.
Yeah, you know? I don't know, it's warm out there.
Yeah, it's going to be in the morning, it's going to be a little chilly, but it's going to be 55 or something tomorrow during the day.
Yeah, it's going to be warm, we're all sick, but then they told us on Monday, like, hey, these people are all sick, and I worked with all of them, I'm like, oh. I should probably go get checked then, because Rose wasn't feeling good Monday, we all went and got tested, and Sam was fine, but then Rose had it, and I had it, but Rose bounced back within, like she felt sick the one day, and then the next day she was happy, so.
Oh, really?
I don't know. She was good.
That's good.
I got wiped out.
Did you? Yeah. I know. Yeah, you can get lost by going off to the right instead of taking that left. Like, there should be some in here, too. Oh, he's got one right here. I think I went off that way one time. There's the stand. What's that? Yeah, the thing is, when the deer come, you don't have a long distance to follow them. You know? So, like, when you see them, you gotta shoot them, pretty much.
Yeah. You said there's some tracks that way?
Yeah. There's one right there for the way out, so that's good.
The other day I was working in the garage taking off a fuel line, and when the fuel line popped off, my pliers hit the lens really hard. I went, oh, and I looked and it was out of focus. Turn it off, turn it back on, it's great again.
So yep, you always got to turn it off, turn it on, yeah.
It's like, I don't understand what causes it to stay like that.
Well, Zachary, he went out to do a little exploring in an area that we don't deer hunt in, so I'm just getting stuff put away. Sarah texted me. She left at 1:11, which would put her up here 5 o'clock, quarter after 5, but then she texted me at 3 o'clock and said that traffic was stopped, stop and go on 35W. And I told her, I said, well, you know, there's 400,000 people, they're going to be in the woods tomorrow deer hunting, and they probably all worked a half a day, and then they're heading up to deer camp. So, not sure when she'll get here, but she's on her way. Few things. I got this new backpack for the deer stand. The thing stunk so bad I left it hang out for almost 2 weeks, and then I finally washed it with scent-free soap, and now it's good. It has really strong smell. Here's four more of those shells. Let's see, your gun hole is what, 4?
Yeah, I think so.
So if you have time to read, I can give you a couple more of these.
I don't think I'll need more than this.
I do have more. Okay.
Are you allowed to use the Don't Estrus and Licks this year?
Yeah.
Okay, I thought there was something about that, were there?
No, I think we were fine with that.
I'm going to get my little thing of Don't Estrus, though.
Is that yours?
This is my hat.
There you go.
I've been missing this hat for like 3 years, and it's my favorite hat.
It was always in the drawer underneath my TV at the Anoka house. Yep, it's been washed in scent-free soap and hung out for 2 weeks.
This is my favorite hat.
Look at that, now you're good.
I've been looking for you forever, buddy.
Yep, I don't throw anything away.
Underneath it.
I like that shirt. That one there, we should be,
this
maybe that's...
been washed quite a few times, too. You gotta wash in the right way, though. It's cold water inside out.
Oh, really?
Because it's screen printed, so if it gets too hot...
Maybe we should make that one the first one we do. How does that look in gray?
Probably just fine.
I just mean gray would be close to this color.
Yeah. I could bring it up on this thing and see.
It's okay. It's okay.
Oh, yeah. I gotta remember my whistle. I always bring my whistle now.
Do you?
If I get lost or something, it's easier to whistle on this thing if I hear you.
Yeah, the cost of bullets now. You don't want to shoot three times. What are you doing? Quit wasting that money.
I only got, what, 5 shells?
Right.
It's like $1,000 with an
ammo. Yeah, 3 shells. You shoot 3 times, here comes the big buck.
Well, yeah, but then it's Sarah. She probably doesn't have a flashlight or something, and it's getting dark.
What is that?
It's Sarah, though. She probably doesn't have a flashlight, and it's getting dark.
No, she wouldn't have one, no.
No. And if she got here, she'd say, I just walked.
I've seen a moose.
No big deal. Yeah, that's right. There was wolves around barking at me. They were cute. You know, that's Sarah.
Like, if you were part of the lottery for buck or doe?
My dad has a card for that.
They send a separate card?
Yep, it's a postcard thing. He said it's sitting in there, so...
I was just curious, because when I seen what I heard about it, I was like, where would they put it on the license?
Right, yeah. Nope, they don't.
And we're allowed to hunt for him?
You, yeah, you are. You're going to hunt on that for your hunt that you're here, and then... If you don't get one, then he's going to let Sarah hunt on it.
Okay. Sarah!
Hi!
You made it!
Yep.
How was the drive?
It was good.
Was it?
All your stuff going on.
Oh,
so.
And that's why it slowed down.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's good. I'm glad you're up here.
When did you get up here?
1:30 or so, probably.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then like this whole week, like up until yesterday at 1 a.m, I have like a convention next weekend. So I needed to like make some new stuff and reorder some prints and stuff. So I was like doing that until... I finally ordered them at like 1 a.m. Then I went to bed, and then I was up before 7.
Right.
So I'm kind of tired.
That's rough.
Yeah.
It's freezing outside.
That's not bad.
It's warm.
Okay, so this camera is ready for morning. I need to charge this battery. The worst part is they've been sitting since... duck hunting, so are they charged now, or, you know?
Yeah.
That one's going to need some.
My markers.
I couldn't find the card, even though I saw it like a couple days ago.
Oh, did you?
But I found that movie.
Oh, the mule one. That's a pretty good movie.
Yeah, so I will find it.
Okay.
Then I'll put it somewhere where I won't use it.
I did find your face mask thingy.
Oh, you did?
Yep, I couldn't believe it. I couldn't find your heavy mittens, though. I did find your thing you can put your hands in.
That's fine. It's not supposed to be cold this weekend, is it?
Nah, that'd be a little chilly in the morning, but heck no, it's supposed to be like 54 tomorrow, so. Hey. And, for supper, Melissa made Sloppy Joe's.
Nice, okay.
So whenever you guys are hungry, we should put those the stuff in there, the potatoes, man. Or whatever, if you want those.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. And then they're like the
and heat those up, because they're going to probably take 15 minutes in there to get five.
And it was like a 19, I think it's 1910 to 19, like 20, mid-20s.
That's cool.
But it was sitting on here, and it was already half off, so yeah. I just yanked it the rest of the way.
Yeah, that's cool.
And then an old watermelon can.
Kraft, great grated cheese.
Chef Boyardee.
Oh, that's very good.
And then I told Sam, like, should I call you soon? She called me. Buggy!
Hi!
Hey, honey. Hey, how are you doing, man?
It's like almost, long time ago, you're up here and you're like, no, it's duck. We're up at duck camp, and you're like, I like duck hunting because I can just come up and like get a vacation and like just have a break from like work and stuff. And now I get what you mean.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but it's you're not working, so yeah, that's why I took the whole next week.
Did you?
Yep.
You're gonna be up here the whole time.
Yep. Unless I want to shoot back for a day or something, like if I shoot a deer or whatever, but.
Are you going to go back at all? Because I'm staying through Tuesday. Are you going to just stay up here then?
I'm just going to stay, like I said, unless I get a deer or I just want to run back for a day or something. Yeah, otherwise I'm going to be up here all week.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I got messed up. Cause
there is veggies up there if you want some.
Potatoes and veggie.
Okay. That's exactly my way of thinking.
Well, it will be delicious. I have a feeling.
It smells good.
Think you're free? You're not. Now listen up.
Sodium fix tomorrow with the jambalaya. I told Sam, I said, don't get the low sodium. Get the regular jambalaya.
Yeah. What was it? Which kind was it?
Zatarain's.
Oh, it was. Like Melissa says, I can't repeat it because the camera's going. But yeah, Zatarain's is not. But that's what we eat at deer hunting, so it's like good.
Mm-hmm.
I look forward to it, and she's like, ready to leave me. Let's see, what do I want? I don't want much out there. Did you get any of...
Oh, I see.
Oh, and there's gloves in here.
I got it.
And then remember, outside is where you have to go through that bag to, here, I've got a knife.
Oh, I just got it.
Oh, you got it?
Okay. Yep.
Your face mask should be in that plastic bag outside. You want to get that ready tonight.
Yeah.
Gloves are in here. And your bed mitten thing is in there. Anybody need dough and heat?
I got some.
I'll take it.
Alright, this is a couple of years old.
Ooh, extra for me.
This is Sarah's dough and estrus here.
Okay.
If you want it.
Yeah.
I prefer the fresh earth. I wonder...
Still
smells like dirt.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how they get that.
Rub it in dirt. Dirt essence, they boil.
As we're driving, I can see them. They're like a half mile up the road. Chunks of rubber are everywhere. And what had happened is they had like a four-place snowmobile trailer.
Yeah.
And they put an old school square baler on the top of it. But they loaded it crooked. And somewhere along the line, the baler shifted and the tire for the baler fell off of the trailer.
Want that top fan going tonight for noise? When have you went to bed early?
You wouldn't believe it. After I moved out, everyone, like Mom, she's on like super early schedule. So then...
Okay, everyone. Well, the wind has picked up just like every deer hunting. But it's 48 degrees outside right now. It's unreal. Going to bed now. Tomorrow we have to be out the door no later than 6:15. Then daylight savings times end, and the following day we'll have to be out the door by 5:15, which is the regular time. So See you tomorrow morning for the Minnesota deer season opener for 2021. Sarah, it's 5:30. It's time to wake up. Sarah, it's 5:45, it's time to wake up.
In the afternoon. Tonight, mostly cloudy in the evening and clearing. Lows in the mid-30s to lower 40s. West wind around 10 miles per hour. Gusts up to 25 miles per hour.
You got your shells and everything? Okay, good. Well, we're off to a very unseasonably warm morning. My truck right now says 49 degrees. I'll probably head back to the tent here shortly. I'll get back there probably a little after 11, and Zach is going to make jambalaya for lunch. I texted with George, and he said they're probably only going to sit until noon. Usually they'll sit until 2 o'clock, and they don't go out in the evening. But today he said with how warm it is, the deer are just going to lay low, so they're probably just going to sit till noon and then call it a day. My dad texted me, he already went back to his cabin, so I'm sure, I don't know if the kids are back yet or not, I haven't talked to them, but had a little bit of rain for a little bit, and then now the sun's out. kids must be over at my dad's. How did it go on your stand today?
Well, it was very relaxing, but nothing happened.
Yeah, I didn't see anything either.
Although people were shooting.
Yeah, I heard some people shooting more kind of northwest. You know, I didn't hear anything. It's funny because where the stand is exactly north of the tent.
Okay.
And it looks like, to me it seems like it's that way.
Yeah.
Which would be more east, you know, but it's not.
Huh. So. Yep. Oh, I jumped a grouse on my way out.
I just saw two when I was driving around.
What the heck?
I was driving with the one. I just passed these people that must have been grouse hunting because I drew the whole loop. And they just passed me. I get up. I go around the bend and a grouse jumps up. It's like, how did I not see that one there?
Oh, was just sitting on the road?
Yeah. Oh. I was sitting there. I wasn't looking. You know, I was just daydreaming, you know. Wow. Yeah, that's when my dad messaged me and said he's going to leave. It was about 10 o'clock.
Oh, really?
And then, like, right after that, I heard the shots. Mm-hmm. And then a little while later, he texted me and said, no shots, no nothing. And it's like he must have been driving when...
Oh.
So that's why I stayed, too. Yeah, I didn't... You just never know.
Yeah, and I was like, wow, that's... Because, like, when it first opened or whatever, there was nothing for a while. And I was just like, oh, there's no deer. But then there's, like, one shot. But then there's those few, and I'm like, oh, maybe they're moving around now instead. So I'm like, I don't want to leave.
Right. You didn't see anything this morning?
Nope. Did you see anything?
No, I heard them few shots. That was it.
Was there a shot at, like, very early? I thought I heard, like, maybe a shot.
I don't know. The ones that I really heard were around 10 o'clock.
Yeah, I heard those. One was coming from, like, your direction, and one was coming from Grandpa's direction.
Was it? Both of them sounded like they were... Well, I don't know. They were pretty close together, so it was hard to... tell, you
know. One person shot twice.
Yeah, the second one.
Yeah. Yeah, I was like, well, it's like 10, you know. Maybe I'll go in, and then I heard those, I'm like, well, I guess I'm staying here for a minute.
That's what we did, too.
Get this fried up. I told Sam, I said, normally I don't fry that. I told Sam, like, Dad wants it fried, so it's not super greasy. And Sam's like, huh, she doesn't really care for this jambalaya. She's like, well... Maybe that's why I don't like it, because it's too greasy.
Yeah, Melissa always fries it pretty hard, and then not really hard, but just the fat out, you know, and then drains it. Yeah.
Sam was like...
So do you guys want to do chuck steaks tonight or pork steaks?
Chuck steaks.
Yeah, that
would be fine. Okay. Yeah, it looks really good, don't it?
Religious.
Took back her spot.
Spot.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, Zachary, he was walking out to his, that one stand that he had in that clearing that's way back there. And then he's going to come back here and go out to the tripod stand. Sarah's going to go back out to her stand. My dad, he's going to sit in that new stand that Zach and I put up a couple weeks ago. Because his hip is sore after walking out and climbing up, because his stand is 21 feet in the air. So he wanted to give that a rest. And I am going to drive over to that new area and just walk down there. I just grabbed a metal chair and sit this afternoon. I want to see if there's any scrapes or any sign there. I mean, it's 59 degrees right now. I don't really even know if I want to shoot it. I mean, I will shoot a deer, but at 59 degrees, you better hope that it's going to cool down tonight, which I think it's supposed to get down to like 35. Well, I'm going to grab my chair and all my stuff and walk in here probably about a quarter mile. Well, a deer stand would be better, but there's a lot of tracks on this trail right here. Well, you can shoot until a half hour after sunset, and I left about, I don't know, 8 or 10 minutes early because I don't have a marked trail. It's not a hard trail to follow, but until you've walked a trail in the dark, sometimes they can be hard to follow. I didn't see anything, but that area does excite me. I want to walk farther because I'm only in so far, and there's like a low spot to go through. And then it goes up and around a bend, you know, looking like when I was sitting in that chair on the right side. And I'd like to see what's down there, and hopefully I can get that done in my week that I'm going to be up here. But now it's time to head to the tent. I told them I would make, I said, do you guys want pork steaks or chuck steaks? And they both said chuck steaks, baked potato, and a veggie. And right now it is almost 10 after 6. Tonight will be the end of daylight savings time, so the clocks will go back. I totally dislike the regular time. I like daylight savings time. Melissa wishes it would never change from the other time. But for me, it's like now the short days and the long winter kind of depression will set in. And then like a switch when it's daylight savings times come, you're out there working until 9 o'clock at night on stuff, and I just really enjoy that. When I was walking out from that stand, I jumped a grouse, scared the crap out of me. I've seen 3 today, and of course I'm deer hunting. Somebody's gonna ask how far it is from the tent to where I just was. I haven't looked at it exactly, but I think it's between 10 and 11 miles. That's from the tent back door to where I park. There she is. I'll pick up a hitchhiker. Want a ride?
Hi.
Hi, you want a ride?
Yeah.
Okay. No, it was pretty dead, but it was a nice night to sit.
It was.
Yeah, I see Zach's car is still there. He isn't back yet.
Oh, really?
Carrie Rod said that they got one doe out of one doe from their group, and he kicked a buck that was bedded down on his way into his stand. Very dead around there. My son-in-law got a video of 5 timber wolves this morning walking by his stand.
Here we go, same thing every time.
All of a sudden there's shooting going on. I'm still in my stand. I told him I was still in my stand when he messaged me.
Yeah.
And of course, right before dusk, you know, you're gonna.
Yeah.
Now you mention it, they don't smell so great.
There's new ones there. I just opened one.
Where? How is it that I'm the last one in?
Right, that's what we were saying. We're
shooting time ended at 6:12.
Oh, I just stayed till I couldn't see how the lights go. Oh,
really? Yeah, 6:42 was the daylight, was the end, which I thought is when we had to come in. So then I'm messaging Sarah, because I couldn't get internet out there. And first I messaged Melissa, what time is it does, because I thought I told you 5:28.
Oh.
And then, so she looked it up and she goes, told me what this town was. I said, I need to know right here.
Yeah.
And then she looked it up and it was 5:42.
Yeah.
And I said, okay, well, that's what you said too.
Yeah.
So then I'm messaging Sarah and it's like, I can never remember leaving my stand when there's not snow on the ground and it's not pitch black out.
Yeah.
So then she looked it up and sent me a thing because I couldn't look it up on my phone out there.
Oh.
And it was a half hour after sunset.
Oh.
Yeah.
Which I don't know why I didn't think of. You know, for duck hunting, though, it's sunset now, which it never used to be 4 o'clock.
Yeah.
So I probably just got it all screwed up.
Huh. I don't know. I just sat till I couldn't see anything anymore. And I walked out.
We'd have backed you up. Don't worry.
When I was walking out,
oh yeah,
I was just like, it's way too warm for this.
Yeah.
Threw a couple of chunks of apple on there, so once I shut this down, it'll start smoking really hard and give these steaks a really good taste. Almost ready. Well, it's my turn to shower. I know most of you have seen this, but there's a lot of new subscribers that probably have never saw the shower set up in the tent. We just heat the water up either on the wood stove or like we did today on the cook stove. And then I have like a travel trailer 2.8 gallon per minute pump. And it gives you a really nice shower with good pressure. Okay, everyone. Well, it's 10:20. We're all going to bed. Daylight savings ends tonight, like I've talked about. So we gain an hour of sleep, but still, you don't gain an hour of sleep because you're going against light, not time, tomorrow. Tonight was a night that we always have, usually at duck camp and at deer camp, where we pretty much just talk about life, how things are going, how things are not going, and it's always good to have that conversation, and I'm glad that we do that. Especially here at deer camp, we get into detail about stuff, which is nice. So tomorrow morning we'll be back up out to the deer stand. Zach heads home after the morning hunt, and hopefully we'll see something tomorrow.
Light on it.
If I had more time, I'd stay up here till Wednesday.
Because that's when they're going to do it?
Yeah, and then just go down and see it, you know?
Right.
Maybe I will anyway.
Cam's parents went last year, and they said it was super cool.
Did they?
Well, I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Night.
Sarah? Sarah? It's 4:30. It's time to wake up. Sarah, it's 4:45. It's time to wake up. Good luck. Hope I hear somebody shoot. Well, this morning I'm just gonna go back down to my far stand. Zachary will be leaving, so I want to be able to be close here and, you know, not have a 15 extra minutes to drive or whatever it is to get back here. Well, it's time for me to head back. Zachary, he just got back to the tent. He texted me. And so he'll be taken off. But, you know, yesterday, of course, was daylight saving. So at 10 o'clock, a little bit after, there was a couple of shots. Nothing before that. Today now, 9 o'clock is what was 10 o'clock yesterday. And a little bit after 9, I think there's been 4 shots now. One of them, though, was directly south of me. And that, if you were to walk straight south, you would eventually hit the tent. Three, however many miles down, you'd have to go. Anyway, there was a shot from there, and Sarah, I texted her. It wasn't her, but it was close. Zachary, he said it wasn't him, but it was really close. George, he texted me back. It wasn't any of them. But my dad hasn't texted me back yet, so I don't know if it was him or not, but he hasn't got back to me yet. At least some people are getting some shooting somewhere. Well, Zachary talked to my dad, and it wasn't him. Oh, it's time to head back, and Zach will head back home. Shooting.
Yeah. You know, Sarah, I only heard the one shot, but Sarah said she heard a couple more.
Oh, I heard like 4 shots, yeah.
Huh. Must have been down your way, because I didn't hear them at all.
No, they sounded like they were south. I mean, the one was south. Yeah, there was one that was behind me, kind of a ways. But yeah, there was like a total of like 4 shots that I heard today.
Yeah, that's what I heard about too.
Well, I only heard the one.
And it seemed like when the wind died down and it got real quiet, it seemed like just perfect, you know, but then it's like, I have no tracks, you know?
I know. We're crunchy. I'm like, nothing ever happened.
So I texted George and said, I feel like I'm in a desert waiting for a puddle of water to come up. You know what I mean? I mean, there's no tracks, so. But, yeah, I'm going to see about that. I went to that portable stand that I have that's kind of dilapidated, but the ones that hold the roof up have broke and shot through the side.
Oh, really?
Because I want to grab one of those and bring it and put it where I sat yesterday. Because if I can clear these little brush out and get on the side of the road, I can still see down this one and see a little bit more down that one. Because it's going to be rainy and snowy toward the end of the week.
Mm.
Then a person, you know, sitting in a chair out in that without a roof would really suck.
Yeah.
So. And this afternoon, did you bring your gun and everything back?
I brought my gun back, but I left my other stuff.
Oh, did you? Okay, because
yeah.
I thought otherwise you could have went. I could have put you in if my dad's not going out in my clearing stand.
I think Grandpa did say he's planning on sitting over there again.
Is he? Yeah. But I mean, we can do that tomorrow too.
Okay.
Because I'll probably go out to that one. I grab my stuff. I was going to text you and tell you that, and I thought, well, I didn't know if you already left yet. Because you're walking back. It takes a while, you know? So.
Yeah.
Right inside the tent?
It might be.
Oh, I see. How did you bring it up last time? Would you have a different? You had a different trailer.
Yeah, I borrowed the snowmobile trailer, I think.
Oh, did you?
Maybe
so.
Yeah, I'll go look again out there.
Does it help us out here anywhere?
Mm-hmm. I know I put it in that backpack, but.
Did you? Maybe it's in there. Hopefully, it didn't fall out in your stand. Thanks for coming up.
Nice seeing you. I love you. Love you. Good luck.
Nice seeing you.
Hope you guys get something.
Yeah, I'll send you a picture if we do.
Oh, yeah.
I told Melissa I'll probably get one, but it's going to take a few days. Who knows? I don't know. I just got to find a place where they're running around.
Yeah.
So.
You have good luck when everybody leaves.
That's because it gets colder. As soon as it gets cold, then it's like... Well, Sarah and I just had leftovers for lunch today. I had some jambalaya and some sloppy joes. And now I'm going to head out to that same stand I was at yesterday afternoon, but I'm bringing out the portable with me, and I'm going to see if I can find a spot to set that up. It's been a really quiet afternoon and evening. Pretty much just your ears ringing. I heard one shot about 2:40 maybe. Otherwise, nothing. Starting to get dark now though. Another 20 minutes and that'll be about it. The camera picks up more light than what's really here. Still 55 degrees. They're saying, like 3 inches of snow in a couple of days. So the weather will switch. Texted me earlier and said he's not going to be going out tomorrow. He wants to get some stuff done around the cabin, so he's not going to go hunting. So I think I might go sit in my clearing stand because I haven't sat in that one yet this year. So, and in the mornings I like to hunt closer like this because 90% of the deer are shot up here in the morning, and if Sarah gets one, I'm close enough to go over there or whatever. We're in the afternoon and I get really crappy cell phone coverage in that stand I just left. Once Sarah heads home on Tuesday, then I may go sit in that one in the mornings, but for right now, staying a little closer to the cabin. Two days of hunting over with and haven't even seen a deer, and I don't feel the least bit frustrated. I feel bad for Zach. I really would like it if Zachary or Sarah or my dad would get a deer, because it's been a long time for all three of them. But this year has just been so hectic right from the get-go in the spring that I think I'm just happy to be up here and not be at work and don't have to have a care in the world about, except for trying to shoot a deer.
Yeah, yep, pretty slow out there today.
Yep. This may be double the size of Texas.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Twice the size of Texas, that garbage thing of plastic. That's ridiculous.
It does say a lot of it is like little micro pieces of plastic, so you can go through some of it and not even know it's really there. But then the middle, it's like concentrated.
It doesn't say if this is mild or medium. It's just buffalo wing seasoning mix original. I guess we'll find out when we bite into it. Pacific Rim?
Oh, once, a long time ago.
It was okay, but I really couldn't get into it. I don't know why.
Yeah, I don't know. It wasn't great.
I think when you're used to watching, I guess nowadays when you watch, Picard with the new spaceship and stuff, that's kind of more like the Pacific Rim one. Back then, I was more used to Star Trek, not all this weird stuff. Maybe that's what it was.
Yeah, it was also, what do they call them, kaijus? So, big monsters and big mechs and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And it's kind of I'm not, super into it.
Right.
Some people love it.
Movies. Still do the same thing.
It's true. You ever do the thing where you're on, Netflix or whatever, and you just scroll and scroll and you can't find anything?
Oh, yeah, Melissa does. I'm usually on the internet, or else, if I'm with a camper. Even when I was at the hotel this week, they had Dish Network or whatever, and I finally found Grit TV, so I just put it on Grit and let the Westerns play.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because, otherwise I scroll and I can't find anything I like.
Yeah, I know. Or I'll watch something for, a minute, and I'm like, no.
Right. Let's see. I've got some here. These must be the ones that I usually will watch, Hang 'Em High, The Fifth Element, 10,000 BC, Time Machine... The Mummy, Star Trek, Discovery, Season 1. Have you seen Star Trek Discovery? I even have Season 2. Oh, that's all there is, Season 1 and Season 2.
I actually don't know.
The Core. They look like they're done. Smaller.
Yep, I'm done.
Okay. Well, you haven't, I think Zach put a piece of wood in when he got back from his deer stand, but otherwise we haven't had to put any wood in today. It's still 50 degrees outside, and it's 71.6 in here. Sort.
Yep, I don't think I needed it either. I used it, my sleeping bag, but I didn't need it.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, everyone, well, it's 9:45. Sarah has just been in there doing work she has an art convention coming up next weekend. So we were watching, or have it in the background, Discovery Season 2, and pretty soon I'm going to go to bed. I'm tired. 4:00 comes pretty early. Sarah. It's 4:30. It's time to wake up. Sarah, it's 4:45. It's time to wake up. Sarah's off to Zachary's stand. I'm gonna go up here and turn around and go back the other direction to the clearing stand. Sarah said that this is the first morning when she feels really tired. Normally she's taking a nap all the time and I haven't seen her nap yet. Maybe she will today. Well, everyone, it's just a couple minutes before 11 o'clock. Sarah texted me at 10, wondering what time I was going to leave the stand, and it's a nice morning, so I thought I'll just sit out here for a while, and I told her if she wanted to walk back, she could, and I think she probably did, because she never texted me anything different. Nice, perfect morning. Didn't see anything. Heard one shot, and that was quite a ways away. But it's Monday, so a lot of people went back to work. Pretty slow, but I was talking to Melissa, and it's like when I got a deer 2 years ago, and then I got one the year before that, or maybe it was the year before that, never on opening weekend. It's always later in the season. I wanted to see if we can zoom in on where my dad's stand is. There's the roof there. Oh yeah, you can see it. It's hard to see in this little screen, but that's where he sits.
that room was a ways away.
Yeah, I heard that. I heard somebody shoot twice.
That one I did too, yeah.
It was like one right after.
Oh, yeah, it was. And it was sort of loud, but I knew right away that, like, it wasn't. I mean, there was no wind. If there would have been wind, and then I started to think, oh, was that Sarah or something? But there's no way to. It had to be an automatic or semi-automatic, you know, to shoot like that.
Yeah, it didn't sound very close where I was, so.
No.
But I was like, why would you shoot twice?
Right, and it was so close together. Like, did he screw up or something?
Yeah, that's what I thought. It was like, boom, boom. I'm like, what?
Yeah, I don't know. Are you going to go to that same stand?
Yeah, I left my stuff out there.
Did you? Do you want to ride down there, or are you going to walk out?
I don't know. I guess I'll walk. It's not that far.
All right, well, if you do walk, walk slow so that you see it in case you see any deer. George and them are out now, so.
Okay.
Remember, you can shoot a buck or a doe right now, so.
That's what I was thinking. I'm like, if anything shows up, to me, it's not tiny.
Well, let's get back out in the woods. I'm going to go to that new stand this afternoon. But I'm going to set everything up in there, even though it could screw it up. I'm going to walk beyond it because I need to know what's down and around that corner and see if there's any sign down there. Well, there's deer sign back here as far as tracks go and everything, but nothing spectacular. It almost looks like more tracks up by where the stand is, so I see no reason to move it back here. Well, I'm going to be leaving the stand here in about 10 minutes. It'll be a little bit early, but Sarah is out in Zachary's stand, which is roughly a 15-minute walk from the tent, which isn't bad when you're walking out there and it's daylight and you can look for deer, but it's a long walk in the dark. So I told Sarah I would pick her up and bring her back to the tent. My dad texted me that his phone is now showing. Right now it's Monday, Wednesday, mainly Thursday, and into Friday, 8 to 12 inches of snow falling up here. Mine is still showing like 2 to 4, so we'll have to see. It might get exciting. There she is! How was it sitting out there? Warm enough?
Yeah, it's fine. It wasn't too cold.
It wasn't as warm as it was last night, but it was not bad.
Nope, I haven't gotten cold one time this year.
I didn't hear any shots tonight, did you?
No, nothing. out there and it's like, and I'm just like, okay, there's not a deer coming for like an hour.
The question always comes up when I'm up here and we're doing showers, how come I don't heat the water up on the wood stove? If you guys have watched enough of the videos, you know that many times I do heat it up on the wood stove. But doing it right here on the gas stove is much quicker. And when we're up here deer hunting, it's just nice to get the chores done. And you know, there's enough going on in the day. Heating up the water leisurely is not something we really want to do.
I just had the potatoes in there first because
they take longer, don't they? That just has to heat up, right?
Right.
Well, the potatoes and the ham are done. I shoved the ham back in the oven so it can stay warm. Sarah's out talking to somebody on the phone, and then she can pick a vegetable, and that'll be supper. I'm just sitting here editing a pretty short video for Northern Seclusion Channel the day before deer camp. And we just have the movie San Andreas in on DVD just for something in the background. Well, Sarah's leaving tomorrow after the morning hunt, and she wanted to get down her purple plums. Let's see if you can make it tonight.
Oh boy, I did already eat.
You always love fruit, so it's just another
piece of fruit. It's always good.
I noticed a little bit of the smell of that creosote this morning, though, because I put stuff in there and shut it down, and there's that wood.
I forgot what creosote was.
Yeah, a couple of pieces of wood must have been not quite totally dry.
I'm thinking about the first time that I took out the prunes or whatever, and everyone just lost their minds.
I know. I don't even know why. Did I just buy them to buy them? Probably because I bought them because they were fruit.
Yeah, and like, I think me and Zach were looking around, we're like, oh, prunes. And then, you know, I'm like, I'll eat the whole can, you know. Don't think much of it. There was seven in there, and they're gone now.
How are you feeling?
Okay for now. Ask me in an hour.
I won't be able to find you in an hour. You'll be out in the house.
This is unbelievable. 2,700 degrees Celsius to 40,000 feet.
No, sounds completely implausible. Unless we're taking off new people.
I can make it out for
you. So what happens to the lake?
Well, that's what we're trying to find out. You think the entire area is becoming stable? I think you can take some kids and really things too.
Okay, I want you to pack up your family.
I'm going to arrange it out.
Everyone should have a chance to go.
Time for bed. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Sarah will head home tomorrow after the morning hunt. Sarah, it's 4:30. It's time to wake up. Sarah? 4:45. It's time to wake up.
Your local forecast. Early this morning, mostly clear. Northwest wind around 5 miles per hour. Today, sunny. Highs near 50. West wind 5 to 15 miles per hour with gusts to around 25 miles per hour. Tonight, increasing clouds. Lows in the mid to upper 20s. Northwest wind around 10 miles per hour with gusts to around 20 miles per hour. Wednesday, cloudy. A 40% chance of light rain in the afternoon. Highs in the lower to mid 40s. East wind around 10 miles per hour. gusts up to 25 miles per hour.
Are you ready to head home today?
Yeah.
How late do you want to sit out today before you head back, since you're heading home?
Let's see. Maybe like, I'm not totally sure, like somewhere between 9, 9:30 maybe.
Okay. It is going to be chilly. Well, when that sun comes, where does the sun hit you when it comes up?
It's like behind me, if I remember correctly.
Oh, is it? For me, yeah. It's right in my face in that clearing stand.
Oh.
Yesterday, the steam was just coming off the front blanket.
Wait, really?
Yeah. Yeah. And then when a cloud would come over, it'd be a little bit more chilly, you know?
Dang. Out, did you just pick whichever one you wanted?
I shot one of the first two. As I'm sitting there, then there's a big, big one. And that other one, that one wasn't bad that I shot, but then this, it was the bigger of those two. And then they were running when they came in to the field, or into the clearing. And then I'm just sitting there waiting my 15 minutes, and all of a sudden this big one come up. And just stood there and looked at me.
Aww.
And nobody else was up here. There was no tags to fill.
That sucks so bad.
Off to her stand, run up here and turn around and go down to the clearing stand. Well, it's a little bit after 9. I have to head in pretty soon because Sarah will be leaving, and then my dad, who I thought was going to be up here all week, then he told me he was going to leave tomorrow after the morning hunt, and now he texted me and said he thinks bad weather's coming tomorrow, so he's going to leave today, and then he might come up for the third weekend. Regardless, I'm sticking around here. You know how it goes. I never seem to shoot a deer until everybody's gone. Sarah's not back. Maybe I'll drive down and pick her up, because she's got to be on her way back. I got back there and you weren't there, so I jumped in the truck and figured I'd go find you.
Yep. Yep, I stayed out till 9:30 and I feel like there should be something here, but there's not.
I know, it was a perfect morning. I thought for sure something was going to come out.
I know.
Did Zachary ever show you that stand that he built?
No, I want to see it.
Okay, we'll walk out there. pull those strings that are on the side of the wall there, and it lifts it up.
Oh.
And then there's a nail. You can do one side at a time. Oh. And then there's a screw above your head, and you loop it onto that, and just it's on the wall.
Oh. Zach made this?
Yep.
Wow, that's pretty good. Dang.
Yeah, it's got the heater. Wow. A nice chair.
It's good I didn't know about it. I've been in here.
I would have stayed all week.
Yep. That's pretty cool, I have to say.
Love you. Thanks for coming up. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Yeah, hopefully maybe you can make it up there. We'll see if the weather's good enough.
Yeah.
It's bad. I can only shoot
what
now because I'm not having tanks to
pull. That's right. I wish we could
leave
your tanks.
Yeah, like beast.
Well, now that Sarah left, it seems kind of quiet and a little bit sad. I like when the kids are up here for deer hunting, and I wish that they, you know, would have got something. I really do. That looks like my dad took off, too. Now it's just me and George up here hunting. I don't think he's going to go out hunting tomorrow. I don't know. He texted me something earlier. Yeah, I don't know. But anyway, it's just him and I up here now. Thank you. Well, I got everything cleaned up and vacuumed in here, so it's back to normal. I just made up some lunch, and I'm just having leftover sloppy joes, a leftover baked potato from last night, and some mixed greens leftovers from a couple of nights ago for supper. Well, let's run out to my dad's clearing stand and sit there this afternoon. I don't know how that's going to go. I mean, he's got it kind of enclosed, but it's a windy area. It's in the middle of that clearing, not up against the side, but let's go give it a try. Well, I made it out to the stand, and with the way he's got this enclosed, it's really not too bad, because that's usually where the wind is coming from, on the sides like this. But what I don't like about it is I can't turn and see behind me, which, you know, you might not look that often, but at least you could take a little bit of a peek. But when you were in a stand like that, it was almost impossible to sit here, because that wind would just freeze you to death. It would just be, couldn't wait to get out of the stand. Just about to leave the stand, but about 10 minutes ago, a deer was right over there. Big body on it. I couldn't tell if it was a buck or a doe. And this is the right side of the stand. There's no way to shoot out of it. I tried to get my gun over there to put the scope to see if it had horns. And I mean, it can't smell me. The wind is coming in my face, but I seen the tail flicker a little bit. And it went off to the right, real slow. I don't hunt this stand much. If I would have waited, it might have walked all the way down and taken a right this way, giving me a chance, but we're running out of daylight, so. Now, at least I seen one. That was awesome. It had a big body on it. If my dad would have been here, he has a doe permit. Well, at least I seen one tonight. I've never liked how that stand is positioned, and it's not my stand to like. It's my dad's stand, so I think that, you know, when you walk into that clearing, it faces straight to the left on the back side of it. I think it should be backed up to the very back of the clearing, facing straight out the way you walked in, so you can cover the whole thing. The problem with that is that you get a lot of wind in the face. I think that's why he has it positioned how he does. But if it would have been positioned the other way, I'd have seen it coming the whole time, could have easily saw what it was. But isn't that how it always is with deer hunting? You know, I mean, not everything is a perfect shot, but I would have really, that was a big-bodied deer. It could have very well been a buck. And I think, of course, I'll go back out to that stand in the morning, but I think that the weather is going to be a lot different tomorrow as the day goes on. I think it's going to get really windy. There's like a 99% chance of 3/4 of an inch of rain or something like that, and then
what day is that? Wednesday, and then Thursday, it'll switch to snow. And then they're talking, I think, 2 inches of snow or 3 inches, and then another inch the following day. So the deer will, who knows? There's not that many deer around, and I don't know if they're going to be laying low or if I'll get to see another one, but I want to be there in case I can. In here, 37 outside, and it's 81 in here. I had that stove almost shut down. I left it open a tiny bit, and I put a big log in before I left. Right. That was weird in your stand too, because I never sat in it. So, like, you know, the little thingies on top, if they flap or something, and I don't know the different sounds to know if it was a deer or not. So I'm looking around all the time. Yep, I would always be looking over there to the right, because that looked like a trail. And I remember when I had a stand halfway between there and the truck before, that's where they came, right down that trail. And I just happened to look over, and I mean, I had already put my stuff in my backpack to leave, and I was just sitting there, but I thought, well, you know, I'm just going to wait until, what's the difference? You know, 10 more minutes. I had 20 minutes until it was end of shooting, so I thought, I'm going to sit 10 more minutes. And then I seen it. Yours is kind of hard to get in. Yeah, it's hard to get in and out of, so it wouldn't hurt us next year to look at the different stands that they have, see if we get one with a bigger platform, because it is harder for you to get in and out, and then we can just take that one and put it somewhere else, you know? You know, then we can just bring it up there and put it all together, and we don't even have to take that one down yet. So, yeah. Right, yeah, I couldn't do it. I tried everything. Tried kneeling. Everything to get my gun up there, and I, but you know, and I mean, if I would have had more time, I probably could have figured it out, but I mean, you know how that goes. You see the deer, you're kind of anxious, and yeah. So I talked to my dad on the phone, and he said, I thought for sure you were calling me to tell me you shot one. He said, every time I go home, you shoot a deer. And I explained to him what happened and about moving that stand back. If I'm sitting out there tomorrow and I think about it, I'll show you, because I can easily put the camera on that tree. So instead of, you know, covering this side of the clearing, you can cover the whole entire thing. And so we are going to move it. But he said he has a hard time getting in and out of that stand with his hip. And I thought, you know, I told him, let's think about buying one that has the biggest base on it. So a person has more room when you crawl up in there, because his gets real tight. It's good once you're in there, but, and he agreed. So we're going to look at that next year. Then I called up Melissa, no, then I called George and told him, because he has not seen any deer at all. So I told him, yes, there still are deer here. And then I called Melissa, because she just got home from work, and talked to her for a little bit. And now I'm going to get that barbecue going, because I want to cook up those pork steaks and that chuck roast and some baked potatoes. So if the weather is really crappy, I won't have to cook for the next few days. Thank you.
Should be good for at least another day, even if the weather gets really nasty. I put a couple pieces of apple on top of that charcoal, so this smells really good. I can smell the pork and the beef and the apple smoke.
Well, I made sure to buy some of these little cans of vegetables, because when I'm up here by myself, that's, you know, all you need. If I do a full can, then I can only eat half of it, so all the canned stuff will have to come out of here when deer hunting is done, so it doesn't freeze over the winter. I haven't smelled a pork steak that smelled that good in a long time. They look really good. Just waiting for the potatoes. They're almost done. That's a good looking dinner. Let's check and see if this is done. It smells really good, but I'm not hungry anymore. Yep, a little red in the middle there. That's gonna be perfect. Okay, everyone, well, it's almost 10 o'clock and it's time for bed. Tomorrow's a new day on the deer stand.
Highs in the lower to mid 40s. East wind around 5 miles per hour, increasing to 5 to 10 miles per hour in the afternoon. Gusts up to 25 miles per hour in the afternoon. Tonight, a slight chance of light rain in the evening, then rain, possibly mixed with snow after midnight. Rain may be heavy at times after midnight. Snow accumulation of 1 to 2 inches. Lows in the lower to mid 30s. East wind 10 to 20 miles per hour with gusts to around 35 miles per hour. 30% chance of light snow, possibly mixed with rain. Highs in the mid to upper 30s. North wind 5 to 15 miles per hour. Up to 30 miles per hour.
Good morning, everybody. I got my truck running out there. I don't have to leave. Well, I can leave like 10 minutes later because Sarah is not here. I don't have to drop her off at her stand. 22 degrees. It's a little bit chilly, but there's no wind out there, so it's not bad. Well, let's get out there and see if we can shoot a deer today.
well, I'm going to sit here maybe another 10-15 minutes and then head back to the tent, get some lunch, probably come back out to the stand tonight, and then the weather is going to drastically change. Well, it's time for lunch. Finally, the end of the mixed greens, leftovers from last night, and I'm finally gonna open up one of these Melissa made homemade salsa, three different types, and they're all absolutely delicious. I know she made a video on it, but I don't know that she has made that public yet. It's really good. Well, I'll be heading out to the stand shortly. I'm waiting a little bit longer than usual because this wind has picked up and there has been some nasty wind gusts. Well, just a couple more minutes left of shooting time, and that's it for today. I really had a feeling that today was going to be the day, but I did not see a thing except for one squirrel.
I put that wood in right before we left and shut everything off. Not the damper or the draft all the way, but she's warm with this many clothes on.
Your local forecast. Late this afternoon, cloudy. East wind 5 to 10 miles per hour with gusts to around 25 miles per hour. Tonight, breezy. A chance of light rain in the evening, then rain, possibly mixed with snow after midnight. Rain may be heavy at times after midnight. Snow accumulation up to 1 inch. Lows in the lower to mid-30s. East wind 10 to 15 miles per hour, increasing to 15 to 25 miles per hour after midnight. Gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Veterans Day, breezy. Rain, possibly mixed with snow in the morning, then rain in the afternoon. Rain may be heavy at times in the morning. Snow accumulation up to 1 inch.
I kind of think that storm is kind of petering out. I mean, it's going to be nasty, but no big, huge amounts of snow or anything. I mean, that could change, but that's what it looks like to me. I just had today, I talked about it before, I had 10 cord of birch that was scheduled to be delivered at the house, and then the guy got COVID, so it's been a couple of weeks. Anyway, he delivered it today, so Melissa's going to go out and take a picture of it for me. And then about a week ago, I had 3 cord, I think it was, of slabwood delivered, so I got a lot of wood to cut up. And all the birch that's showing up will have to be cut and split, so she's going to get a picture of it for me, though, so I can see it. I'm sure it really screwed up the yard going back behind the chicken coop and everything to get over there. I was just texting with my brother Chris. Him and his wife Teresa, they have 160 acres over in, that's by Park Rapids, Minnesota, so it's more north central Minnesota, and versus this is way northeast. Anyway, a lot of deer there. It's a farm country. And he saw some big bucks on trail camera, and he did shoot one, a six pointer, which wasn't, you know, a smaller six pointer, but a deer's a deer. And he's been waiting for these big ones. Yesterday he saw 10 deer, and he didn't shoot any of them, you know, because their season runs through Sunday, and he's going to go home Saturday. So Friday, today is Wednesday, is doe day, when he'll shoot one doe to fill whatever permit. So he's been waiting for these big deer. Yesterday he saw 10 deer, today, none. And he's the type still. He's always been this way. He sits from morning until night. He does not leave the stand. And we did that together when we hunted together years ago, but that's not for me. So, yeah, so he said he's got a course enclosed, heated, it's on his own property stand, but still, that's a long time to sit in a little stand. But yeah, no deer today. I'm bringing everything in tonight because that wind is blasting off the lake, and it is supposed to rain, and once it starts raining, it's going to be blasting and everything will get wet, so it might smell a little bit like the tent, but that's the way it's going to be. This is Sarah's stuff here. Almost ready. I just ordered a new pair of these boots. I bought these, I think I've had them for 10 or 12 years. They don't get wore a whole lot, but the back is ripped out of it now, and they have that 1200 whatever, thinsulator, whatever's in there, and they've just been a pretty good pair of boots for me. So, and now this year Sarah didn't bring her boots up. She forgot them or couldn't find them or whatever, so I thought I'm gonna I almost bought a new pair last year, but with COVID going on, I was going to the store and trying to find them, and things were, you know, you couldn't find exactly what you wanted, so I ordered them online today, and then I can leave these up here, and then if somebody forgets their boots sometime, there'll be a pair that's here. Or I don't even have to bring any boots when I come across on the winter trip, because I just come across in my tennis shoes, and I can just use these once I get here. Last night I started editing this video, the one that you're watching, because now I have, maybe we talked about it last night, 18 folders so far of video clips. That wind is really starting to whip out there. I have a little 4-inch, I don't know what that's called, inline or whatever. It's just a 4-inch stovepipe, but it has a fan in it. And I use that to blow the warm air from the main part of the tent, because it's up higher right there, into the bathroom here. Otherwise it does help get it warm, because I mean it still stays chilly back here, but this does help warm it up quite a bit. That water got a little bit too warm, so it's going to take about 10 minutes before I can shower. It's getting windy. At the beginning of the week, it was easy to find what I wanted to wear, because like, oh, I'll wear that. Now when I get to towards the end of the week, it's like, oh, I don't know if I really want to wear that one. Is that going to be warm enough? Well, I just had leftovers for dinner tonight from the stuff that we cooked last night. And I've just been sitting here editing the video that you're watching right now. I put Deep Impact in on DVD for something to play in the background. And there's no snow or rain yet. It's real windy, and the wind will creak the tent. I mean, I don't hear it move. It's just, you hear the insulation, you know, click a little bit. So it'll be interesting to see if and when the actual precipitation starts. It'd be nice to get at least an inch of snow, though, because we would be able to see the deer much better and see tracks and see what's going on. But anyway, that's all I'm doing tonight. I've just been sitting here editing. Well, there's still no rain or snow happening yet, but it's time for me to go to bed. Put a couple more pieces of wood in the wood stove. Well, it's 5:30 right now.
Normally I would have left at 5:15, drove out to my stand and started walking out there about now. But it's nasty. It's mainly rain, but the snow is mixed in. I'm going to run out to that stand that Zachary made in a little while, but there's no reason to get out there early.
Expect any deer in their right mind to be walking around in this today. I remember, I don't know, it was a few years ago. Can't remember what morning that was, but it was nasty. It wasn't like this. It was snowing and it was real windy. And I said I wasn't going to go out, and then I changed my mind and I went out. And that time I went out and it kind of calmed down about, I don't know, 9 o'clock or so. It was a nasty morning. And sure enough, a deer came out, but at that, you know, that day the weather got better. And then they came out where today it's not supposed to get better. And this is more rain than snow right now. So, but like I said, no deer in their right mind. I don't care what their mind is like, I just want them to have some antlers. I don't think I'm not going to need my heavy jacket or anything, because Zach put a heater in that deer stand. I mainly just want to try that thing out on a nasty day like today to see what it's like. Really comfortable in here. Well, I'm not going to sit here that much longer. I think I'll get in the truck and drive the loop and see if there's any other hunters that were out this morning, or I doubt I'd see any deer tracks right now, but see what's going on. My dad texted me earlier and asked if I just stayed at the tent today, and I said no, I'm out in the stand. And he said that trail that the deer run up there, he put red ribbons so you know where the trail is, but I can't see red. I even looked through the scope of the gun trying to find him, and I could not see him anywhere. I mean, I know about where the trail is, but it's always nice when you can sit in a new stand and know exactly where it is, especially when it changed and it snowed a little bit, so everything looks a little bit different. I sure can't complain about the stand, though. Nice and dry. It's windy out today, and the sides weren't banging around or anything. Things that cover up these windows. Well, it's definitely raining. You just can't really tell in there with all the big tree cover over the stand. I'm just gonna wait a minute for that to flame up and then shut the stove down and we'll drive the loop. What a rotten day. This is where I get ruts in the driveway this time of year.
nobody has driven through here today at all yet. Few more months, it'll be time to make the trek across the lake. You see right over there, there's a beaver swimming around. Lunch is ready. Trying to use up some of this stuff because I end up buying it and then we don't use it. Anyway, that does not look like macaroni and cheese over there. It looks like macaroni and cheese soup. I don't know. It's got to be edible though. Looking at my Ring doorbells, it looks like it's snowing at the farmhouse. Yeah, look at that. Definitely snowing there. You can see the snowflakes coming down. Here it's raining. This is south. You know, this I'm farther north here than they are at the farmhouse. Well, as much as I hate to say it, I think I'm going to run out for the last about hour and 45 minutes and try Sarah's stand. That's the only one that's really blocked the way the wind is coming from. Has some tree cover that she's got the umbrella over the roof that should help a little bit. It's an older umbrella, but and I do have an orange emergency poncho thing. I think I go nuts if I have to sit in here all day long, all night long. If temperatures would be more normal, what they're supposed to be, and we got this kind of rain, it would have been all snow, because right now it's 41.9. We should definitely be in like the low 30s, upper 20s. We would have had, well, we've so far it says 1.40 inches of rain. For every inch of rain, is 10 to 12 inches of snow. So we're just under a little under an inch and a half of rain. Yeah, you're talking 15, 16, 18 inches of snow would have fallen. That would have been exciting. It sucks after it falls and you got to deal with it, but it's exciting when it happens. Well, I think it's time to head to the tent. Chalk that up as an afternoon with no deer. My legs are wet, my back is wet, but the umbrella kept most of me dry. The temperature about 40 minutes ago was 40 degrees, and right now it's down to 33.3. Of course, that doesn't look like it's snowing or anything. That's probably, I'll have to look at the radar and see, but the temperature is dropping fast.
I'm just looking at the radar here. I think that the weather is about done. Supposed to be some snow showers and stuff tomorrow, but it seems to me that it's all curling up towards the north and the west. I was hoping that we would get a couple inches of snow tonight, but I mean, if we don't, it doesn't matter. It's way better than what we had today.
Okay, everyone, well, it's time for bed. The rain has stopped. It's not snowing. The temperature has dropped. We'll see what happens tomorrow. Good morning, everybody. Looks like we have a light dusting of snow on the ground. The weather station hasn't had sun for a few days, so it's not working right now, but my phone says it's 31 degrees out there. And the wind died down.
According to the weather on my phone, it's supposed to only get up to 33 today. And then tonight's low is 20. So at least we're not gonna be getting into the 40s. Temperature will stay chilly and maybe those deer will move around. Okay, everyone,
I've been out here about 5.5 hours on what should have been a perfect hunting morning. It seemed perfect. I saw one squirrel. Time to head back to the tent, do some lunch. I don't know, I think this afternoon I might go sit in my far clearing stand. This one's getting a little boring. Looks like the weather station came back alive after it got light out today here. Well, we might as well get back out to the deer stand. I'm gonna hunt tonight, I'm gonna hunt tomorrow morning's hunt, and then I have to head back. And then, let's see, 4 days from now, or then 4 days from tomorrow, I'm going to come back up for the third and final weekend. I think my dad's coming up then, but he has said that before and then not come up on third. It all depends on the weather, I guess. But I'm planning on being here. And when I come up at the end of the week, then I can run out to that other stand that I have that ground blind. If my dad's up here, I didn't want to really hunt back there if I'm the only one up here, because how do I get it out of there and get it into my truck and everything? So I'm just sticking around here. Okay everyone, shooting time is over. It's a lot brighter with that snow on the ground. If it's windy like this in the morning, I'm not even gonna come out. But if it's not, I am gonna come out and sit for the morning hunt and then I'll head back to the house. Let's go back to the tent. Warm up, it's chilly out here. Nobody has even driven through this afternoon.
Well, I think tonight I'm just going to clean everything up in the tent. I looked at the weather, and I was going to leave the canned goods up here until third weekend when I come up, which is, like I said, it's 4 or 5 days, and I'll be back up here. But one of the nights is going to be 10 degrees, and there's a good chance that that could freeze them and, you know, swell them up. And last year when I come up, I left them, and some of them were slushy. So I might as well just box those, put them in my truck, and then just haul them back up with me when I come up towards the end of next week. Today is November 12th, and for those of you that have been longtime subscribers of Jones Act Survival and Northern Seclusion, and people that comment a lot, you know, like there's a certain amount of people that like always comment, and so people get to know their names. Anyway, Bailey, who it's her birthday today, and I usually would never say anything like this, but Bailey has been a subscriber since 2015, and I don't know when she ever, you know, she comments, and she'll get a whole bunch of likes on her comments, but she is turning 13 today, and in 2015 she started, so she was 7 years old, and she comments, and I always comment back. And then I also text with her dad all the time. So I get updates on stuff, and he asks me how things are going for deer hunting and everything. So anyway, I did say that I would do a happy birthday to Bailey, and because she's been here a long time. So even when we had, if you guys remember, 3-4 years ago maybe, we did the kids did the live stream from the tent here. She was the person that we put in charge of them being the moderator. So that's how tight she is. Like, she'll comment on Zachary's videos, and, you know, she just feels like part of the family, kind of, because she's just been around for so long. So happy birthday, Bailey. I think I need to get my butt busy here and get this tent cleaned up. And I'm just going to do leftovers for supper again tonight. And I'm so glad I'll be done with them, because I was talking to Melissa today earlier, and she's going to make meatloaf tomorrow and some asparagus on the grill and steam some cauliflower and some broccoli. And then, when I harvested all the potatoes, we had purple potatoes, red potatoes, and then whites or russets. And she's going to make purple mashed potatoes for me. She's as strict on her keto right now, so she can't have the potatoes, but she's going to make some for me, so I'm looking forward to that. That's going to be lunch, so I need to, unless I shoot a deer tomorrow, if I do go out hunting, I need to be out of here, I don't know, no later than 10 if I want to have lunch, you know, by 12:30, 1 o'clock. I'll have that for dinner tonight. I know I answered this, I think, in the questions and answers video, because people always ask, how can I leave stuff up here over the winter? Everything that's in jars here is dehydrated. This is jerky. Dehydrated fruit cocktail, green beans, grated potatoes, and that can stay up here because that's not going to explode. And then stuff like, this is my spruce honey, and so that's fine. I leave my syrups are okay. I have bottles of homemade wine that I made and a bottle of wine that my brother made that I leave up here, and they're always fine too. So my box isn't big enough. I'm gonna have to put it in this. I think that's all the canned stuff. I always have to be careful because sometimes a jar or a can will sit behind here and I won't see it. I had one sticking over here this time that I almost missed. Ketchup and mustard, that can all stay. That's where I always stick all my dirty clothes. I guess I can throw this out. It was expired on 30th of August of 2018. Never been refrigerated. Freezes. Gets warm. I use it a few times this year. It's fine. This one, 25th of August, 2016. Same thing. I use that one this year a few times too. If Melissa ever comes up here and decides to go through everything, I'm not going to have anything left at the tent. She would throw all that stuff out. That's all I'm doing tonight. It's already 20 minutes after 9. I can be out of here within a half hour tomorrow. So, you know, the once it snows like this, but things aren't frozen, it's the dirtiest that the tent gets because you bring in pine needles and leaves that stick to the bottom of your boots. So I really wanted to get it vacuumed. Okay, everyone, well, it's a little bit after 10. It's time to go to bed. The wind seems to have died down, so I hope to be in the stand in the morning.
Well, good morning, everybody. I woke up at 4 o'clock and there was still some wind out there. It's not bad. I mean, you guys watch enough, I sit through anything. But there's some stuff I need to get done at the house before the work week. And I thought I'm just gonna pack my stuff up and head out and get that done so that I can get back up here on Thursday. I texted George to see if they saw any fresh tracks out there, and he hasn't texted me back yet.
That wind has completely died down now. It's a pretty morning. I just got stuff I've got to get done. I've been up here for over a week.
Leave that for the birds. Maybe I'll leave with some hamburger buns too.
Okay, everyone. Well, thanks a lot for watching this first part of Deer Camp 2021. Like usual, we had weather changes, didn't see much for deer, and we still have more days to go. See you guys on the next video.